but these were only the commonplace designs, used to enrich the hundreds of functional rooms that filled the palace. The more important rooms, such as the Great Hall and the Royal Quarters, were decorated with scenes from legendary battles or stories concerning the gods. Some pictured mythical creatures, whilst others showed human figures at work or play. There were naked boys running foot races, others wrestling or boxing, yet more competing with javelin or discus. It was a place of such wealth and luxury that the halls of Olympus itself would have struggled to surpass it. The hunter's return had filled the palace with the hubbub of many people. Odysseus kept his men confined to their rooms on the upper floor, but outside they could hear the many kings and princes dispersed to their separate quarters to bathe and put on fresh clothing. Only when Clytemnestra, still dressed in black, came to bid them join the feast at her father's request, did the Ithacans leave and descend the broad steps to the floors below. Filing out across the central courtyard towards the entrance to the great hall, they passed the carcasses of scores of bullocks, sacrificed to bring the blessings of the gods and feed the many revellers for whom the four or five roasted boar would not. The blood ran down in thick rivulets across the muddy floor and gathered in pools of deep red. The smoke from the burned thigh bones and fat which the priest had offered up to the gods choked the air and put a pall over the face of the early evening moon. Before Odysseus and his men had even left their rooms, the sound of feasting had been like the hum of 10,000 bees in their ears, but as they stepped into the great hall the full force of it burst upon them like a roaring sea. Wine-lubricated tongues fought to gain ascendancy over each other as well-fed, big-voiced men shouted to be heard by their neighbours amongst the drunken cacophony. Laughter, music, excited voices, arguments and shouts from one side of the room to the other filled the air, and the babble of sound was matched by the chaos of movement. For each guest there must have been two slaves, rushing here and there with craters of wine, baskets of bread, platters of meat, and small tables on which to set them.